Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's showtime. The Chariot Room is proud to present the First Lady of Comedy, that knockers up gal, Miss Rusty One.
I can't tell you how to launch Miss Rocket. Oh, why oxygen is in the atmosphere. But the way to make your mark in those moments after dark, that's why Rusty is here. I can't tell you how to climb up Mount Olympus or how to play the saxophone by ear, but to buy the proper cup so you can keep your knockers up, that's why Rusty is here. Now the class will come to order. Everybody pull up a chair. It's time you learned a little something. I see a hell of a lot of boobies out there. I can't tell you how to marinate a herring or make rabbit out of cheddar cheese and beer, but the right way to cavort at your favorite indoor sport, that's why Rusty is here. Is that why you're here, dear? To learn about sex? Is that why you're here, sir? Live it up. What do you got to lose? Connie Francis likes to sing of teenage romance. Sophie Tucker brings you sentiment and corn. But to sing about the sack and the mattress at your back, that's why Rusty was born. Lady Bird can tell you all about the White House. Mickey Mantle knows how baseball should be played, but to keep you on your toes when your fella comes and goes, that's why Rusty was made and made and made and made and made. I can see that all my students are assembled. If there's any questions, I've a willing ear. If you want to tame your guy or find another way to fly, don't be afraid to ask me, dear, 'cause that's why Rusty, that's why Rusty, that's why Rusty is here. Well, as most of you know, our subject is sex. It always has been sex, and it always gives me a personal thrill to sit here and talk about something everybody's doing. Oh, don't you laugh. There may be a few people here that figure they ain't getting their chair or something. That's all right. Are you a married fella? You're right. And you're married, and you're happy, and you're getting it. Isn't it wonderful to get married and know that any time you want it, you can have it by just give a little nudge, and there it is. Waiting, madly, passionately panting for your divine embrace, oh great white father. What happens in your house? The kids yell about they want a drink of water? You mean you're not getting it? How many children do you have? Oh, you mean you only did it twice, and then they keep bugging you? He looks like a mad, passionate person. I just sort of looked at him, and I picked on him and said, there's a guy that's getting it any time he wants to get it. And I start talking to him about getting it. He says, no, I don't get it, because the kids keep hollering with the glasses of water. It drives me out of my mind. I can't get no sex at home. I have to go outside. You didn't mean with another woman, you meant outside in the backyard, didn't you, sir? Why not? Why not do it in the backyard? You're in sunny California, it's beautiful out here. If you like to do it in the backyard, go ahead, invite the friends and neighbors. It's called the barbecue. Happy barbecue party. He's wild. Don't laugh, sir, you're gonna get it too. Isn't he going to get? Why do you say no? His whole group is. His wife is out of town, not his old lady's out of town. What do you think? You're talking to some dinweb up here or something or other. You say his young lady, his wife, his spouse, his love, his mother, anything, but you don't say his old lady's out of town. That's crude. Where is your old lady?
She's still out of town.
She is? If there is anything that I, Rusty Ward, can do to help you in your hour of need, any little thing, nothing,
it's better than nothing.
Thanks, pal. You mean if we do it, it's just going to be a favor to me?
Me? It's been a week.
It's been a whole week and you haven't had it?
No, but I'm looking.
You're looking at it, honey. I feel absolutely thrilled. This fella hasn't had it for a whole week. And how long was your wife home before you didn't get it either?
A week?
A week before she came. Well, boy, they brought you in here to get you lucky. They didn't know that we have a raffle here every night, and we pick just a fella like you. And we hold this man up, and we say, okay, girls, you want to cheat a little bit? You're all married ladies. You want to try a little something different? What the hell can your husband say if you win it in a raffle? You have to use it, right? Don't laugh. He's our raffle prize tonight, ladies. Get your tickets. Get them right over here. Buy him by the book and have a bundle. Isn't that wonderful? What is your name, sir, so the girls will know what they're getting?
Shorty.
Shorty? Well, girls, that was the end of that raffle. If you think these ladies are going to buy what they can get at home, Shorty, forget it. We got a good group tonight, don't we? I want a prom. Here's a drink. Come on. Everyone wonders why I booze when I work. I like to drink. Come on. I was brought up in old barrooms, honey, and I learned how to booze. Come on, fella, drink. I want a promise right here with a drink in my hand to a toast to you that every man sitting here tonight who had guts enough to bring his own wife into my show, I want a promise that this man is automatically going to get lucky tonight. Here's to it, fellas. What are you drinking for, Shorty? I just told you weren't gonna get it.
Bottoms up.
Bottoms up to you too, dear. Oh, he's beautiful. Are you feeling all right with your little whiskey sour? Don't get sicky. Don't get sicky. No, really, a lot of ladies come in here and they're not used to drinking. They're not the kind of women who do drink, right? You're not a, I wouldn't say you're a drinker. No, the whole table don't look like they're drinkers, you know? They're just sort of sitting there sharing an old beer and an empty whiskey sour here. All the fruit's gone. You see what's left of the drink when you take all that garbage out of it? Nothing. And you kids have been married, let's see, 10 years or under, right? Have you been married over 10 years, you kids? You're not married at all? Are you married, lady? Are you married? No, you're not? Well, that's all right. Sometimes a lot of the students come in here. Someone said Rusty Warren is lecturing at the Anaheim Bowl again. Come in and we'll pick up a few things. You know. Don't worry, if there are any questions during the show, please don't hesitate to ask, young lady. Please. Oh, don't wonder. You're married. I can't tell you nothing. We can laugh at the things we do together, but I can't tell you nothing new, right? How many years have you been married over there? Oh, you're not married? You look married. You look so comfortable with the fella like you know him for years. You're cozy. Are you sharing an apartment and trying out like if you got married to see if you could live together in the modern manner? Could I recommend an apartment? You mean it's apartments are hard to find in this area? No, I've seen so many lovely apartments, vacant, ready for you. You don't have to buy furniture, just wall-to-wall mattresses. Try out marriage. I'm not asking to make a whole big McGiller about it. Just try it out. Right? Do you cook, young lady? You're a bad cook. He's a good cook. Sounds like a Hollywood marriage to me. I don't know. Are you working, young lady? Maybe the lady's working. He's going to stay home and cook. That's very good. Very good. Wouldn't that be wonderful? That's a turnabout, but that's something to think about. What the hell? What if all you guys, you think we got easy jobs? Every man out here goes to work early in the morning and he works very hard and comes home and everything. Think, oh boy, it'll be a woman just one damn day and lay around on my butt all afternoon talking on the phone, listening to television, and don't do nothing but carry a child for 9 or so months and just sit and look at it for the rest of our life. Oh, that's an easy damn job. Well, let me tell you, try it. I think a woman could put up with the stamina of a very hard day at the office and come home to a happy-faced fella who had a calm day laying around drinking beer and watching a ball game. Can you see him now? He'd be such a mess doing what we have to do in the daytime. By the time he'd get down to the laundromat and find out that all the stalls are taken, he has to sit and wait and watch a damn program he didn't want to see in the first place, and find out when he goes to his purse he hasn't got a quarter. And he forgot to bring the detergent, and he has an argument with the guy next to him because that's another nut whose wife is working, right? And he's got to do the laundry. The guy next to him figures out, well, he's using the wrong detergent. Well, now two ladies can discuss this very calmly. Oh, yes, because women are calm, natural people. But two guys, what do you mean I'm using the wrong detergent? You're out of your mind. Don't yell at me. Before you know it, a big fight starts, right? And the whole thing all kind of what? One lousy box of detergent. Men can't take the strain that women can take. Can you see a man if he was to carry a baby for 9 months? Just picture it. Oh, my God. He carries on enough when the belt doesn't go and this is too tight in the front here. And when you loosen up the crotch, it's killing me with the slacks already. Can you see him trying to carry a kid? And he'll be up in front of the mirror looking at himself. My God, I can't see nothing no more. Where's my shoes? Where did my feet go? Don't laugh, sir. When you feel a pain around your chest, your boobies are getting bigger. Watch out. No, I think we better leave things the way they are. So it makes me feel comfortable to know that if there's a war, he's going to go out and fight it. I'm going to worry about him, but he's going to be out there fighting it. I don't want to fight a war. I don't want to do nothing that's going to hurt me. Because I'm chicken. The bad truth is he's chicken too, but it doesn't look good on him. He's got to be a hero, right? Oh, yeah, and they say men get scared too. Yeah. I've had a guy scared. You know how to scare a guy? Call him up and say, guess what? Scare the hell out of him. Maybe it doesn't scare so much when you call your own husband. It's when you call your neighbor's husband and tell him, guess what? He's been scared. Look at him over there. His wife doesn't even know, but someone called him on the phone and said, oh, sweetheart, guess what? All the way from Malibu, right? Oh, we have one. Well, I'm going to do a song now for the men who may be scared or may have been scared at one time or another. It's a tune I like to dedicate to the PTA. That's Pill Takers Anonymous. And our motto is, just take a pill a day to keep the stork away. Tra-la-la. If you're inclined to lay, why not try PTA? The letters are synonymous with Pill Takers Anonymous. Just take a pill a day to keep the stork away. No more fertility, you'll have sterility. Goodbye to worry when in a hurry. Why end up scared? Take a pill and be prepared. Take the pill, and you won't get caught. With this pill, which now can be bought. Tra-la-la. So you won't misconstrue what these pills do to you. Use them to your heart's content while you are pleasure bent. Then if you should decide to take the kitty ride, just stow the pills away until another day. And with him by your side, you soon will swell with pride. And he can say, I made her what she is today. But till then, take the pill and you won't get caught. Yes, till then, take the pill, which no can be bought. Tra-la-la. So for the sexy life, free from the care and strife, just take a pill a day, and you won't get that way. And if by some mistake your pill should fail to take, you're still home free, 'cause there's a money back guarantee. But till then, take the pill, and you won't get caught. Yes, till then, take the pill, which no can be bought. Girls, what do you got to lose? After all, it's guaranteed by good housekeeping. That's true. No, the pill cannot fail, at least I hope not. No, the pill cannot fail.